Acclaimed by Discover magazine as one of the top 10 most significant scientific achievements of 2019, researchers with the UC San Diego Stem Cell Program, working at the Sanford Consortium for Regenerative Medicine, witnessed and then investigated the emergence of complex neural signals in self-organized colonies of cortical neurons. They are called cortical organoids, or brain organoids, because they have many of the characteristics of a developing brain. The researchers have been generating and working with brain organoids for some time, but what they observed was a surprise even to them.
My lab has been working with brain organoids for a while now, and they mimic a human development at the molecular level as well as the cellular level. The organization of the cells resemble some of the organizations that we see during development. As these organoids mature, we can identify different cortical layers being formed. We have been measuring the activity of neuronal networks by using multi-electrode arrays, or MEAs. After about 4 to 6 months of culturing these organoids, Priscilla and Kleber from my lab, they came to me and said, "We have a big surprise."
The whole well was synchronized, and there was like a lot of activity going on. We were never able to see so high levels of activity, so we were just very surprised.
So it was a very unexpected result. So that what motivated us to further investigate what was going on.
The researchers performed single-cell analyses on the organoids, looking at gene expression in nearly 20,000 cells to confirm the cell types necessary to make a functioning network. They verified the presence of neural progenitor cells and their subsequent differentiation into four other classes of neurons as the organoids matured: intermediate progenitors, glial cells, and both glutamatergic and GABAergic neurons, which are critical for the production and transmission of neural signals. In particular, after 6 months, the neurotransmitter GABA was detected.
These results suggest the presence of the basic components for the generation of a neural network in a developing human cortical model.
The researchers conducted functional tests at the single-cell level, which confirmed that excitatory neurons were functioning, and larger-scale observations with MEA over a 10-month period revealed increasing frequency, complexity, and organization of signals as the organoids matured. But what could all this signaling activity mean? To understand the significance, the researchers turned to collaborators who specialize in understanding neural electrophysiology.
So that's when we turned our collaborators in the Wojtek lab. This is Brad Wojtek at Cognitive Neurosciences here at UCSCG.
In the Wojtek lab, we look at a lot of human electrophysiology, so signals like EEG, ECOG, and MEG. And the reason why these oscillating organoids are interesting is because oscillations are a ubiquitous feature in animals as well as humans. So that's why we think the organoids that are oscillating are special. So what you're seeing in these traces are the total number of neurons that are firing at that time. A higher peak means there are more neurons or more action potentials that are emitted. At 6 weeks, the neurons don't really synchronize. They fire sparsely and randomly. Starting at 2 months, they start to synchronize in these burst events. They have these periods where all the neurons in the network activate at the same time. Starting at 4 months, they spike really quickly once, and then they spike again within a couple hundred milliseconds. So that's what we call an oscillation. And then at 6 months, there are more and more cycles in this oscillation. It's very regular. You see the same oscillation. But at 8 months, the trajectories become less stereotypical.
The Wojtek lab revealed multiple frequencies of oscillations nested within each other on scales from tens of seconds down to milliseconds, which was an important revelation.
So this nestedness or cross-frequency coupling is another feature that we see in human as well as animal electrophysiology.
With the oscillations exhibiting known characteristics of neural signaling, the researchers went a step further in their investigation.
If we have that much activity, it is possible that these networks will generate brain waves similar to the ones captured by EEGs.
To investigate this, they developed a model from existing data to which they could compare the organoid signals.
So we were able to find this clinical data set, actually, of preterm infant EEG data. And so this model is basically saying, if we just trained a very simple machine learning model on the baby's EEG features to predict how old the babies are, can we then use that to predict directly, using the organoids features, how old the organoids are?
While on the surface, the EEG data and the MEA data look wildly different, the researchers looked closely at agnostic characteristics that both data sets shared, namely, duration of an oscillation event and the interval between the events. The model was trained using data recorded from actual neonates, aged from 25 to 38 weeks. What did the model reveal?
In the time span where the model hasn't seen the EEG data, so before 25 weeks, it predicted really poorly for the organoids. Whereas starting from about 25 weeks, the prediction became a lot more correlated with the actual developmental time of the organoids. Therefore, from the model's perspective, there are similar features in the EEG data from the preterm babies, which it has seen, compared to the organoid data, which it hasn't. When we use only those features, this model was able to predict what the actual culture age was. It might suggest that we can use them as models of neurodevelopment, for example, or patient-specific models to test out drugs or disease interventions.
This is one of many things that makes this discovery so significant. It holds the promise of changing the future of neuroscience while improving the human condition.
They are an attractive model to start exploring these early stages of human development. There are several neurological conditions and psychiatric conditions where the problem relies on network. For example, autism, where the genes that are implicated in autism actually are very active in these very early stages of fetal brain development. These are conditions that affect millions of people in the entire world. So having a model is instrumental if you want to create better quality of life for these individuals.